name is Karl Flesch. I'm a board member of the Trenton City Museum here at Ellarslie and Cowboy Park. And I'm also on the collections committee, and my involvement with today would be this exhibit on Trenton Central High School, which is on the building of the building from 1922 to about 1932. The building of the school was a problem because the city did not have enough money, had reached their bonding cap for bonds. And the New York State Legislature was controlling this because in one of their rules for their institutions to loan money for bonds for cities was an artificial cap applied on the city of like Trenton. However, the cap was higher for cities in New York State, so there was a disadvantage for out-of-state cities for bonding. And in 1928, they finally rose the cap, which gave Trenton another $9 million available to go for bonds. And it was through that the city was able to finally get the money to build the school through their bond act. And the other thing that was good about building the school during the Depression was the cost of materials were very low at that point in time. And also there were a lot of people out of work. So it was a good idea for the city because the city was a very industrial at that time, and it would give jobs to the city's citizens of Trenton to build the school. Another hat that I wear is I'm also on the board of the Trenton Historical Society, and for the last 10 years or so, we've been advocating the saving of the school, to modernize the school, and we were always trying to advocate that it would be cheaper to rebuild the school as a modern school than to tear it down as they're now doing. So that was one of the big impetuses, and growing, I didn't go to this school, I graduated in one of the surrounding townships. But when I was going to high school, Trenton High School was the school to go to. It was the school that had all the subjects that you would need to get into college, and they had great football teams and basketball teams and great center of learning. It was the school. Also, my mother went to the school. She's a graduate in 1942. So I just felt that it was a great building that needed to be preserved. It was a landmark for the city, and it was made to last. It wasn't meant to be torn down any time too soon. I think 82 years old is old, but not that old. And I believe it could be modernized to a modern school today. With the building coming down, Richard, the president and co-coordinator of this exhibit, we had gone through the school in the past summer, going through a lot of the rooms and seeing what we could save possibly from the school and ask for the school to give us. So that was the impetus of we need to have an exhibit because we've now gathered all these great things. And at the same token, there were things that were being removed from the school that were not going to us to go to our museum, but the school was taking down, such as the various plaques that are around the room. They would be taken down for self-safe storage while the building was being torn down and built again. So it was an opportune time to show these things to the public. I think it's sad to see the school go down. I kind of have mixed feelings about do I want to see it come down. I mean, actually, you know, take photos of it because I'm an historian. I like to photograph things in the city, but I think it has to be done. And I've come to the point now that I think we need to worry about the new school, and I think those that are concerned about anything in Trenton should be concerned about what the new school will look like and make sure that the city gets the finest high school like they got back in 1930.